Hi, and thank you all for attending. Before we begin, I'd like to give a special thank you to the adjudicators here today, Dr. Robert Livingston Aldridge, my teacher, and Professor Douglas Johnson. I'd also like to thank the other members of the composition department, Dr. Scott Ordway, Dr. Stephen Kemper, Dr. Amanda Hardberg, and Dr. Melissa Dunphy. With their support and their guidance, I was able to prevail these last 4 years, and I'm incredibly grateful. I'd also like to thank my parents and the rest of my family for being in attendance today and for supporting me as well for these last 4 years, and all of the performers that have been working with me, getting these recordings together. Once again, thank you everyone for coming, and please enjoy the concert. The first piece on the program is Corners of the Ravine, written in March of 2020. Being home for the first time allowed me to see places from my childhood in a new light, and it was rectifying these two perspectives, being home versus being away from home, that resulted in this piece. It is an exploration of nostalgia and wonder and circumstances. I'd also like to take this time to thank Shanae Wu Robeson for performing and recording this piece virtually. Without further ado, please sit back and enjoy. This next piece is one close to my heart. Back in October of 2018, I was approached by a close friend about commissioning a piece for the upcoming Rutgers Undergraduate New Music Ensemble concert. While I had collaborated with other musicians and performers in the past, this was one of my first commissions, and being able to workshop through this piece with someone familiar was a great experience. I'd like to thank the performers, Peter Houdalis and Ross LaRocca, and all of the time and dedication they put into this concert and this recording back in that October of 2018. So, please relax and enjoy this funky little piece with memories attached.
Thank you.
Untrodden Ways was originally written for the Workers' Composition Music Assembly concert. I had never written for voice before, so the project, while presenting its challenges, also presented great success. The narrative arc of the piece, yearning and pining to acceptance, was interesting to translate to music. I'd also like to thank the performers Michael Lazaro and Alexander Bui for working with me during one of my first completely virtual collaborations and creating such a stunning result. So please sit back and enjoy Untrodden Ways.
She dwelt among the untrodden ways, beside the springs of Dove. A maid of whom there were none to praise, and very few.
Images for solo cello had been a brainchild of mine since the end of my sophomore year. I had been listening to Bach and Britten solo cello suites nonstop and eventually found myself craving my own. The two images are split into two preludes. Prelude number one, which focuses more on the emotional versatility of the cello, and prelude number two, which focuses on its dramatic abilities. During this time, I'd also like to thank Sarah Bish, the amazing cellist in the recording. Working with her during these past virtual recording sessions was a dream, and the finished result is something any composer, anyone, would be proud of. So thank you, Sarah. Without further ado, please enjoy two images for solo cello.
Thank you. Thank you.
confetti is one of my favorite pieces to talk about because it has such a nice story. It was originally conceived as a tone poem dedicated to the way that my close friend described a flock of birds flying over the Raritan River. We were laying down in the lobby of this building called Mortensen. I just hear her say, "Look, it's bird confetti." And I get to see this giant flock of birds fly up over the Raritan, like disperse in between the clouds. And it, to her credit, it did look like bird confetti. It was originally written as a chamber orchestra piece, but as time went on, the need for additional textures became very apparent, and this led to the final orchestral score. Exploring the images of a flock of birds weaving in and out of the clouds hung over this inky black water. It's one of my favorite younger pieces of mine. So please enjoy, and I hope you can see a little bit of bird confetti in it. At this time, we will be taking a short 15-minute break, and we will be returning soon. Hello, everyone, and welcome back. Thank you for coming back after that short break. This next piece that I'd like to introduce is one of the most important pieces to me that I had created during my time at Mason Gross. It represents a lot of compositional growth and change and struggle, and is what I consider the turning point in my compositional career at Mason Gross. String Quartet Number 1, I originally started writing bits and pieces of my freshman year and didn't start really seriously looking into until that summer, where I looked through every anthology, every little bit of paper that had like a mention of a string quartet I was drawn to, I was reading. And it took me another year after that, finally finished the beginning summer going into my junior year, this whole string quartet. That whole process completely changed my approach to composition, my perspective on composition. This is one of the pieces I am the most grateful for and the most excited to present to you today. So please, sit back, relax, and before we begin, I'd like to take the time to thank these amazing performers, Hannah Lee, Catherine Lim, Ashley Tonner, and Ji Chen Lee, for taking the time to sit down and play this 20-minute piece for you all today. Thank you, everyone, and please enjoy.
Thank you.
The last piece in the program is one of my most recent pieces, King's Highway is on Fire for orchestra. I drive home for the weekend to work and I pass by this one stretch of highway called King's Highway, and during the fall you can't see anything as you're driving past it, but as soon as you turn onto it there's this explosion of like orange and red in the trees. And always seeing that in contrast of gray skies, in contrast of sunny skies even, is so striking. And every time I would drive past it, I would find myself almost captivated. I would turn my head a little bit to look. And it struck me so much that I started to associate little bits of music with it. And as those little bits of music grew, I realized, well, I should probably write this down. Unfortunately, this piece was not performed by a large orchestra due to everything being virtual, but I'd like to give a special thank you to Thomas Naziola for this digital rendition. So, please enjoy, and once again, I'd like to thank everyone for coming. And thank you for sharing this experience with me. It means the world. Thank you, and please enjoy. King's Highway is on Fire.